Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ear. Okay, wrong speech. But it isn't. Now think about that. I'm supposed to talk about culture, subculture, undercurrent. We tend to forget that actually all our culture is coming from a subculture. After all, Shakespeare was considered very, very low in society. I mean, actors, artists were subculture. Now, what is culture, by the way? So culture is the mainstream product of a society, what is accepted, what is followed by almost everyone. But then we all know, because all belong to one, we have what is called subculture. Now, technically speaking, they always call undercurrent. But if you go to the dictionary, undercurrent is actually the current beneath the sea, which I guess figuratively it sounds okay, but it might not be what we're looking for. Now, subculture. Why we call it subculture? Well, first of all, it's a Latin word. Of course, you know, Latin. Sub means beneath. But it's also been said that imagine a culture like a tree, okay? It grows, but it cannot grow without a seed, which is beneath the soil, and then, of course, the roots, which are also beneath the soil. So it's important for the growing of everyone. Now, another thing that is important of subculture is because we'll help you. Now, if you all belong to one, no matter what, and it will help you feeling maybe less alone, or maybe to belong to someone, or to have that feeling. Now, again, this is very sterile. This is very in the air. Now, let me take you a little bit through history, and let me explain you a little bit about this ancient or not so ancient subculture. Now, first of all, let's go to these days. According to the internet, which is, of course, the source of all knowledge, whatever it is, the number one subculture in the world is TikTok. Okay? So you think, really? TikTok means short videos? Now, let me just share with you a short story regarding how important it influences. Now, there is this very, very young guy from North Africa that emigrated in Italy 5 years ago, and he started making videos just because he was unemployed during COVID pandemic. And he started making this video in which he will make fun of people that will try to solve small problems. He will make this very funny face. Now, if you look on it, his name is Kaby Lame. So he started with like a few hundred followers, just people that knew him. Now he's 7.5 million followers. It has been called to LA to assist to one of those social media events. Not only that, but he's becoming so influential that actually he's helping his life. In which way? Well, he's not legally in Italy. He never actually got any paper. But since now he became very famous, a lot of people is noticing him. So because he's famous, he might get citizenship. I mean, he has been in Italy for the past 10 years anyway. But in the end, this is an exact example of how a subculture like TikTok can actually influence life or create another kind of culture. Later on, we're going to talk about the bad about this. Okay, now let's go with the good one. Another subculture, which is very, very famous, is what is called the trifecta, which is manga, anime, and cosplayers. Again, you might say, really, reading manga is subculture? Well, yes, it is. Because trust me, comic books are still considered something for little kids, or at least a certain amount of people. And they all believe that until the Avengers movie came out and they made $7 billion and people say, yay, comic book money. Okay? So they start noticing this part. I mean, they've been publishing the Avengers since the 60s. I wasn't even born. But now they're noticing. So, cosplayers. Let's just take the cosplay. You know, during COVID, all the comic conventions were closed. But the cosplayers actually continue. And they made videos on YouTube, I mean, in their home. So they never really stopped. And these people continue making money because of visibility and all the ads they can include in their video. So this subculture is actually influencing the way business was conducted during the past few months. Again, another bright example. Now, let's go back a little bit in time, and let's go back to the 90s. Now, during the 90s, a lot of subcultures were born. To contrast the 80s. Now, why the 80s? Because the 80s were the crazy times, were the times in which people were actually dressed very bizarrely, and dancing to bizarre music. I know, I was there. I was one of you during that time. But then, during the 90s, they create another subculture, which was the grunge, the emo, other people that were against that. And they also changed the culture of those times. Let me give you another example. During the 60s, a little bit back in time, there were these people called hippies. They were not dressing with long hair, peace and love, all flowers and everything. They didn't last very long. But you know what? When the hippie movement finished, this subculture migrated into something else. So one hippie was thinking, okay, I don't want to do anything in life. Maybe you share that feeling. I mean, it would be lovely to not to work or not to do anything. So let me just invent something in which I can make money, but not really working. This is how Starbucks came to be. Starbucks was invented because no one wants to really work. I mean, after all, if you are a barista, you just latte, cappuccino, you're done. Money. Okay? Another couple of hippies or coming from hippies, they also wanted to do something else. So they say, okay, what can we do? So they start mingling with new technology, and they start creating machines that they were very easy to use and processing. And then a couple of years, let's say a decade later, they were billionaires. Please don't forget that Bill Gates and Steve Jobs were nerds and hippies. Don't forget that. So this subculture actually creates something. Let's go back a little bit more in time. During the 1700s, Romanticism, okay? You all study, or if you were awake during the literature class, Romanticism was born because it was a subculture. Oh, they talk about love and everything can be conquered by emotion. So, you know what they create? Very fast. They create horror novels. Horror novels create Sherlock Holmes. Sherlock Holmes create the modern culture. Forget about anything. Whatever you're reading and watching as a movie, owing to them. So subculture creates something. Now, what is the bad of that? Well, the bad of that is that subculture can be very soup, can be very under. And sometimes it can be used by certain organizations in order to mine or to undermine a society. That's what the danger is of subculture. So subculture need to exist. But sometimes people that belong to need to understand that it needs to grow. It's the same thing with high school. What is the bad thing about high school? Is that it's going to end. Okay? Meaning that you enjoy it, you do a lot of things, you learn a lot of things, but then you just move on. Okay? So the subculture that you belong to might not be the same in very few years. Now, I want to finish, because I promise I will keep this under 10 minutes, okay? There are people that are staring at me. The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, which, by the way, is the title of a movie during the 60s that we call Spaghetti Western, and they also were a subculture. Wherever you look at it, you can find that a subculture actually influenced us. So if you think that you are very shy and you only enjoy watching cats videos, and you only enjoy talking with only two people in the world, no, you're not strange or bizarre. You are creating your own subculture. Thank you very much.